today. Happy Monday. Today, I wanted to make sure I asked you, because I've been forgetting at the beginning of all our lessons, to ask you how your day has gone. How are you feeling today? So let's just take a minute, think about your day, think about everything you've done so far today, and I'm going to think about my day too, all right? And let's just think for a minute. How do you feel right now? How are you feeling today? Can you show me with your faces? I'm going to pay close attention to how you're feeling today, because I really think that's important to know. Wow. I see all kinds of feelings going on out there today. And I am with you. In any given one certain day, I can feel all kinds of things. And I bet you can too. And that's great. God gives us our emotions too, doesn't he? And he's right there with us. So let's begin. Should we start with a prayer? Let's pray. How about today we pray the Hail Mary? We're going to be talking about Mary in just a little while. So I thought it would be great to pray to Jesus's mother. All right? So let's begin. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you for praying with me. I love to pray together with you. It's one of my favorite parts of RE. So thank you for doing that with me, friends. Well, today we are going to talk about something that I think pretty much everyone has had experience with. Have you ever been invited somewhere before? That's the question of the day. Have you ever gotten an invitation that maybe looks something like this and says you're invited? It doesn't have to look exactly like this. It doesn't even have to have an invitation to it. Maybe you've been invited to a party at a friend's house before. Maybe you've been invited to play with someone after school. Maybe you've been the inviter and invited someone before. And I thought that would be a great question of the day to go with our gospel talk of today. All right, so just take one moment, just 1 minute, and talk with the person that you're with, the adult that you're watching this video with today, about being invited. If you've ever been invited somewhere, or if you've ever invited someone to do something with you before, okay? So when my fingers get to three, pause the video and talk with the person next to you about that, okay? Here we go. One, two, three. Hello, we're back. I bet that was a really good conversation, because I think most of us have had an experience of inviting someone, maybe to a party, maybe to do something fun with us, maybe to celebrate something, or been invited somewhere before. And I wanted to tell you about a story that happened to me when I was your age. Well, I don't know if you know this about Miss Kathy or not, but my birthday is in the summertime. And one time, my parents said that I could invite some friends over to my house to celebrate my birthday. Oh, I was so excited, because I had never had a party at my house before where friends could come over and celebrate with me. So I decided that we would have a roller skating party. We would all bring our roller skates and roller skate in the front yard, roller skate all around the neighborhood, and then we'd come inside and have cake and play games. I was so excited. Well, I don't know. How many of you out there have summer birthdays? Anyone? Can I get a summer birthday out there from anyone? Well, if you have a summer birthday, you might have experienced the same situation that I had when I had this thing about invitations happen. Because my birthday was in the summertime, I sent out invitations to all my friends. I couldn't give it to them at school. I told them, you're invited to my party, when it was, what time it was, and everything, that they would bring their roller skates and we'd have a great time together. Well, the day of my party came, and the time of my party came, I was so excited. I kept waiting inside for the doorbell to ring. I was nervous, I was happy, I couldn't wait for everything to start. And the time of my party arrived. No doorbell. That's okay, people are late, things are going on, it's summertime, people are busy. 15 minutes went by, still nobody. 30 minutes went by, still nobody. I waited a long time, let's just say, for the people I had invited to my party to come. And nobody came to my party that day that I had invited. I was disappointed, but my mom, she was awesome. And she explained to me that summertime is hard. When I was young, when I was your age, families went on long vacations in the summertime. They went away. It was hard to find people. People were busy. We didn't have cell phones back then, so we couldn't just call someone up and say, "Where are you? Come over. You missed the party." But my brother and sister were pretty sweet to me that day, and they ended up going around the neighborhood and getting all the neighborhood friends that they could find come over and had them come over to our house, and we had a great time. So all's well that ends well for my roller skating party. But it has to do with, I wanted to tell you that story because it has to do with our gospel that we just heard yesterday for the 28th Sunday of Ordinary Time. And if you read it during Mass yesterday, or you could find it in your Liturgy of the Word book that you have, it's a great example of people being invited and not coming. In this gospel from Matthew, we hear a parable. And the parable Jesus tells us is about a king whose son is getting married. And the king sent out invitations. He prepared a banquet, a wonderful feast that you can't even imagine how wonderful this banquet was going to be for all of the invited guests. Well, when the time was for the banquet to happen, the party to happen, the king got very, very upset because none of the invited guests came to the banquet. The king got so mad, he was so disappointed and so upset that none of the guests would come. Nobody he invited came to his son's banquet for his wedding. So he sent his servants out into the street to gather all the people that they could find. It didn't matter who they were. It didn't matter. It didn't matter if they were young or old or rich or poor. The king wanted them all to come to his son's banquet feast and participate in the joy, in the celebration. Well, this gospel is really, Jesus tells us, about the kingdom of heaven. So Jesus will use a parable about a banquet, and that represents the kingdom of God, or heaven, right? And you can imagine what heaven would be like when we get there. I'm sure it will be a wonderful, amazing, fantastic banquet or party, one that we can't even imagine how wonderful it is. Well, in this gospel, the king, who does he represent? Can you guess? Tell it to the person sitting next to you right now. Who do you think the king represents? If you guessed God, you're exactly right. I knew you could get it. And who do you think the guests represent? Who do you think the guests that are invited to the wedding, to the banquet, are in this parable? Can you tell the person next to you? Tell the person next to you if they're sitting on that side. Yes, that's us. The parables and the gospels are usually about us. And in this gospel, God and Jesus are trying to teach us a very important lesson about being invited, right? It might not look like an invitation, a beautiful pony, pretty pony invitation like this one. But every day, God invites us to come and participate in his feast, in his banquet, in his kingdom. every day God is reaching out to us, giving us an invitation to participate and to have a chance at eternal life with him. And not only us, but he's asking us to invite others as well, right? So we have to pay attention. It's so hard. It's so tricky. But God will invite us sometimes in little ways, and sometimes he'll invite us in big ways to participate in life with him. Can you think of some ways that God has invited you lately to be close to him or to participate in life with him? I have an example. God invites us. He invites me. I know he does me, and I'm sure he's inviting you too, to participate in Mass, to come to his feast. We could come every day if we wanted to. Mass happens in our parish every single day. And we know for sure that God's feast is present there. And God is present. The saints are present. All the holy men and women are present there, because it's the time where heaven and earth meet, right? So definitely we're invited in that way to be with God. Do you think when we take time to pray, God's inviting us to spend some time with him? I think so too, right? God invited me to spend time with him in a really funny way just this week, and it completely passed by my head. I had been sent on an errand for work to get something to eat for someone in my office, and I was happy to do that errand. I was happy to go help this person get some lunch, and so I got in my car, thought I was leaving with plenty of time, really early. I was leaving so early that I thought I might be leaving too early. I thought that if I get the food right now for this person, it might be cold by the time they get it to eat. But I thought, no, better to be early than late, right? Because I don't like to be late. Miss Kathy does not like to be late, even though sometimes I am. Just ask my children and my family. Anyways, I went to the place where I was supposed to get the food from, got in line, and I waited, and I waited, and I waited, and I waited some more. I waited so long that I started to get upset. I started to get, what is going on with this line? I waited not 10 minutes, not 20 minutes, not 30 minutes, but 45 minutes. And during that time, I was pretty upset. I was just looking at my watch, tapping my foot, doing everything that you could imagine, crossing my arms, getting really upset. Every now and then, I would hear a little voice inside of my head, inside of my heart, saying, just spend some time with me, Kathy. And I'd just brush it away. I'd hear that little voice again. I'd get that little feeling of peace trying to eke into my heart while I was waiting and waiting and waiting. And I would just keep brushing it away with my anger and my impatience. And when I look on that time now, it's 45 minutes. 45 minutes, boys and girls, that God was inviting me to spend time with him. Can you believe it? And I missed it. I laugh about it now, even though I was really mad in the moment. But God was inviting me to spend some time just waiting in line with him. I could have been talking to him. I could have been praying with him. I could have been listening for his voice. Remember that whisper from last week's gospel that Elijah heard from the cave? That's where God's voice was. He was whispering to me that day too, and I missed it. He was inviting me to spend time with him. And I know God's calling to you too, to spend some time with him in prayer, to listen for his voice. Maybe he wants to help you with something that you're struggling with. Maybe he just wants to be close to you. Maybe he wants you to be close to him because he loves you that much. That's how much he loves us. God loves to spend time with us. So this week, let's try to pay close attention to all the times that God is saying, hey, you guys, you're invited. You're invited. That's right, you. To spend time with God in a very special way, whether it be at Mass, in prayer, or waiting in line for something. God's right there waiting for us. One way that I know that God is inviting all of us to be close to, not just him, but his mother, is that October is the month of the rosary. Did you know that? Da-da-da-da. I have a beautiful rosary right here. I'm going to tell you about this rosary in just a minute. It's very special. I'm going to tell you how you can get one too. Okay, but October is the month of the rosary because just last week we celebrated the feast day of Our Lady of the Rosary. So in the month of October, we really take our church, our faith takes this month to really focus on the rosary and maybe pray the rosary more than we normally do. And if you don't know what the rosary is, that's totally okay. The rosary is not only an object, it's right here. I bet you've seen one of these before. How many of you have seen one of these before? How many of you have one of these at home? Wow, that is
Not
a
a lot
lot.
of you.
Jesus's mom, but she's our mom in heaven. She loves you all very, very much. And the rosary is a beautiful way to pray. And I have a little activity for you all to do today. It's a little book to make. It says My Prayers of the Rosary book. And I put my name right there. But I'm going to link some pages that look just like this. All right. They're prayers that we use when we say the rosary. All right. We pray the sign of the cross, the Apostles' Creed, the Our Father, the Fatima prayer, the Hail Holy Queen. And it also will have the joyful mysteries, the sorrowful mysteries, the glorious mysteries, and the luminous mysteries of the Rosary, so that you will know which parts of Jesus's life to focus on each day that you say the Rosary. Sometimes saying an entire Rosary can be a little bit daunting. It can be a little bit overwhelming, especially when you're at the age that you are. So sometimes even starting just with one decade of the Rosary is a great way to start with your family praying the Rosary. Just with 10 Hail Marys and one Our Father. All right? That's a great way to start praying the Rosary together. Because saying all 5 decades at one time can be a little bit, it can be a lot, definitely. So don't feel like when you start praying the Rosary together, you have to say all of the decades at one time. Just start with one decade. It's a beautiful way to start your family on this beautiful tradition, especially during the month of October when we celebrate Mary. So this little book, when you cut out all the pages to it, it has all the prayers of the rosary. And if you don't know the order to pray it in, just look it up on the computer. Just type in how to pray the rosary. And it has lots of graphics and lots of explanations about how to pray the rosary. But if you do this, be sure to do it with your adult that you're with in your family. All right? Don't do it alone. Definitely do it with your family. All right? When we pray the rosary, we pray a lot of Hail Marys. And we do that because this prayer is really a way to reach out to Mary. And whenever I pray the rosary, I truly feel like I'm holding Mary's hand. I think I read that somewhere or heard that a speaker talking one time about praying the rosary. And that when we pray the rosary, it's like reaching out to Mary and she's holding our hand as we pray. And so that is one reason why I love to pray the rosary, because holding hands with my mom in heaven, oh, that's amazing, right? I would love to be holding hands with Mary. And truly, when I'm praying the rosary and thinking about the different mysteries of Jesus's life, the times in his life that we focus on while we pray the rosary, it helps me feel very close to Jesus and Mary and to really take part in Jesus's life. And I hope you'll feel that way too. When you get to the part in the book where it has, well, really, you can do this on any of the pages of the book because you can see that on one side is the prayer and on one side is a blank page. You could draw a picture on this page to help you to illustrate the side that the prayer is on. Or look right here for the joyful mysteries. I drew a little picture of the angel Gabriel during the Annunciation because the Annunciation is when Gabriel came to Mary and asked, "Will you be the mother of Jesus?" So I drew a picture of one of my favorite archangels, and I'm sure he's one of yours too, Gabriel the archangel there, right? You could draw pictures all throughout this book to help you really understand what each page is talking about, all right? So this is a great little activity to do together. And I also wanted to mention one more thing, that if you don't have a rosary, please come by the parish office and just ask for one. We have a whole basket, I don't know if you can see this basket, full of rosaries. We have a wonderful teacher in RE, Miss Charlene. Boys and girls, how many of you know Miss Charlene? Have you had her in first grade? Or maybe you have her this year in first grade as your class mentor? Her sister's church makes these rosaries and gives them away for free. And Miss Charlene asked her sister's church to make these rosaries just for our parish so that we could give them to people who needed rosaries, who don't have some. So if you don't have a rosary, if your family does not have a rosary, or you don't have one and you would like to have one, ask your parents if you could come by the parish office anytime and just ask for a rosary, and we will happily give you a rosary, all right? You can keep it in your pocket. You can pray with it. It's a great tool to help us learn about our faith, all right? So I hope you have a wonderful week. I hope this week we kind of tune in and pay attention to all the ways that God is inviting us. Not sure if we're getting an invitation in the mail, but you might. God might send you an invitation. You just never know. That God is wild and crazy. He does the funniest things. Maybe it'll be standing in line waiting for something like I was last week. Maybe it'll be an invitation to participate in Mass however you can this week. Maybe it's just an invitation to go outside and tell God three things you're grateful for that He gave us this week. All right? However God invites you this week, I hope you will say yes and come to His banquet. All right? Have a great week, boys and girls.